Hi everyone, this is Katie with a quick overview of how to use Screencast-o-matic. Screencast-o-matic is a really nice tool that allows you to record your screen and your voice, and you also have the option of recording your face with your webcam as well. And it has a lot of variety of ways you can use it. You could simply record your voice with PowerPoint slides, or you can record how to do something in a particular software program or how to fill out something online. So I'm going to walk you through a quick overview. And the first step is to go to the Screencast-o-matic website. You don't even have to log in unless you're planning to upload your finished recording to Screencast-o-matic, but I'm going to recommend that you use YouTube, so it's not even necessary to log in. Notice that I have a message up here. You do need to watch for messages such as this one and allow Java, for example. You also have to install a launcher the very first time you use it, similar to Blackboard Collaborate. So when you click Record Screencast, if you haven't installed the launcher, then it will ask you to, and I have, and so in this case it's asking, do I want to use that? And I'm going to say remember so it doesn't ask me the next time. So now it's going to record the launcher. And so this next step is the important one, and basically you have these options. So you can record just your screen, just your webcam, or both. And then here you have a max time of 15 minutes, so for most projects that's going to be plenty of time. There is no editing, so that's the downside of using one of the free tools like Screencast-o-matic or Jing. J-I-N-G is another one. Jing does require that you install the software on your computer, but it's an alternative to this. And then you need to make sure you have the correct microphone chosen. So you're on your system, you may have multiple microphones. You want to make sure you choose the best microphone. I'm just going to go ahead and choose that one. And then if you're going to have any audio playing through your computer, you'll want to turn that on, and I don't. So I'm going to just, for example, change it to just screen, so it's not recording my webcam and my screen, but just my screen. And then basically the really important thing is that you resize this black and white window to the section that you want to record. So you would open up whatever it is you're going to want to record. So let's say it's PowerPoint, and you would go ahead and just, you know, resize the window. So you probably only want to record this part. So you just move the screen around and align the black and white so that you're recording only the part you want to record. You can obviously both resize the black and white outline and resize the window itself to make it fit nicely. And if you're going to be also sharing some websites, get those open and ready to go. So that is the next step. And once you're ready, you can go ahead and hit record. And if you do want to stop, you can always pause as you're recording. And if you mess up, you can just start over again, because there isn't really an editing feature here in this free tool. So basically, you're going to just go ahead and record. And it counts down. I'm going to go ahead and hit pause here because I'm already recording with Camtasia in order to make this video for you. So it'll just count down right here and let you know how much time you have left. And then at any point, you can go ahead and hit the pause. There will be a pause button here. You can pause so that if you want to switch from PowerPoint to possibly something online, like let's say you want to share something on a website, then you can move the website around so that you could share something that is online or whatever, and then you can pause again and go back to the PowerPoint. So it's pretty seamless. So you just have to hit pause and record, and then again you can only have up to 15 minutes here. And then when you're finished, it's going to I'm just going to record just a fraction. We'll see what happens here. I don't think it's going to work because I'm recording already in Camtasia. Yeah, it's not really going to work. But when you hit done, it does give you a little bit of a preview. Now, we're not seeing that because, again, I'm recording in Camtasia to make this screencast. But you'll be able to play it back and watch it and listen to it. And if it's good, then you'll be able to, you'll have three options: save the video, upload to Screencast-o-matic or upload to YouTube. And I would recommend that you upload to YouTube. So YouTube is, of course, a Google product, so you can log into YouTube, and you do need to log into YouTube to be able to change the privacy setting. So when you're logged into YouTube with your Google account, you should see your picture up here in the right corner. And all you have to do to get to your videos that you've uploaded from other places, if you saved it as a video, then you could upload it here. But if you've uploaded it automatically to YouTube, you need to go up to this button and go to your channel. And when you're on your channel, you'll see the Video Manager button at the top. And this allows you to see all of your videos. So let's just pick this video, for example. If I go to edit, that's where I can easily change, and this one's already set for unlisted, but here's the privacy settings, and private has some issues. It's just difficult to do. So I would recommend unlisted. And what that means is that people won't be able to find it unless they have the URL. So the URL is going to be listed right here, or if I go back to the initial screen, if I clicked on this to actually watch this video, then of course the URL appears up here at the top. And so either one, I can get it that way. I can go down here to share and use that one. So any way you want to get that URL, that's how you're going to share it with your class and your instructor, simply copying and pasting that URL. So that's why this is a nice method, because video files are very large. You don't have to deal with trying to turn in a huge video file, which can be problematic in Blackboard. And so this way, you're directly putting it on YouTube, and all you have to share is a link to your video. So hopefully this will help you. I'm sorry I couldn't show you every step of the way. It's a little difficult to record a screencast of how to make a screencast. I'm using a different tool, Camtasia, which is not free, and it is similar, but it certainly has a lot more of the editing features. Now, one thing I do want to mention is that laws are changing, and whenever you're working with videos, choosing videos other people have made or making your own videos, you do need to have a transcript and or captions. So I do recommend, as you're working on this, it might be really easy just to type up, as you're planning your presentation, type up your script, even if you're not going to follow it exactly, and that way you have a transcript. And so that way you're covered. You could submit a transcript if you were going to be putting this really on a website, that would be required. So I just wanted to mention that. Well, have fun screencasting.